matter what else happens, the guards will always be grateful for everything you've done.
Cause trouble in Whiterun and I'll haul you into the Dragon's Reach dungeon myself.
The best. Can you be my mother?
You're someone who can get things done. I like that. A citizen of Hafingar has asked for our help. It seems that a predator has invaded their home, and someone needs to clear the beast out. Be cautious. Beasts are not nearly as predictable as men. Give the thing a quick death.
Thank you. need something? What a waste.
You're someone who can get things done. I like that. I'm sure that the owner of that place is relieved. They certainly came through with the coin. Harbinger, I'd be honored if you joined me in my search. I had once heard Skior and Kodlak talking about the totems of Hersey. Simple-looking objects that could channel the powers of the werewolf in new directions. Once Kodlak began looking for his cure, I'd wager Skior didn't bring it up again. But I was going through his things and found a book I had never seen before, all about the totems. I've been talking to my sources around the holds, and think I may have heard where one of them lives. Wanna come along? We hunt together.
Captain Gallen does the business for you. I'm just a ship.
definitely matches the description of the totem from Skior's old book. Let's get it to the Underforge.
Talk to Captain Gowland if you're looking to book passage.
The spirit of Skior is with us on this errand. Friends like you are hard to find, and very valuable to me. You're someone who can get things done. I like that. Right then.
Remarkable, isn't it? This tomb has been hidden for, well, who knows how long? Many centuries. I've had a look around, and the only interesting thing I've found is this inscription here, and a switch below it. Now, I'm not sure if you can read the dragon language, but this This seems to be a riddle of some sort. A sacrifice will bring you closer to that which you seek. I wonder what it means. At times like this, history truly... Mind your step. There seem to be some corpses strewn about on the floor here. Who knows what dangers await us in this place? Perhaps something is meant to go into the fire? Yes, of course. It said, a sacrifice will bring you closer to that which you seek. Right behind you. Walking in these chambers is like walking in the past. You lead the way. Walking in these chambers is like walking in the past.
Yes!
Along with a puzzle. Continue along the path. Don't tread where you've been. Interesting. Well, I'm pretty sure about two things. One, the riddle is most likely referring to these flat square stones. I'm not going anywhere near them. The way. was afraid the earthquakes might have done serious damage here, but the tomb seems to be in fine condition. What the inscription says. All men must die, often by their own means. Sounds rather grim if you ask me. The inscription must be a reference to these pillars. Three pillars surrounding a central one. Perhaps they're connected somehow. They also have glowing stones of some kind. Vaguely similar to drawings I've seen of objects called impact stones. Well, see what you can figure out. I'm going to inspect these pillars further to see if I missed something. I wonder if I should have brought more torches. This is most exciting, wouldn't you agree? walking in these chambers is... Well, there's a warrior, an archer, and a mage. Perhaps each statue is meant to represent a different method of combat. There's probably an exit through one of these sarcophagi. Let's get moving. This tomb is a discovery of great significance. We'll be remembered for this. Walking in these chambers is like walking in the past. Ah, so that's where that goes. All right. Here's another riddle. Stay your course, to idle is to die. Well, at least it's straightforward. There appears to be a switch of some kind here. I'll just stand over here while you flip that switch. By the nine, I've never seen anything like this. I think you were going to survive that fall, let alone those things that were down there. This is most exciting, wouldn't you agree? Thank you. have these platforms appear once you finish them. You'll want to find out what's down in that water. Maybe those half claws you found would fit in here if you put them together. It seems these rings can be moved. Perhaps there's enough undamaged text in these etchings to tell us the combination. Walk it. Ah, yes. Here's something. The first one has to do with a breeze, or maybe it's wind. The second one mentions the night sky and the moon. And the third has something to do with fire. It also seems to mention scales. That's all I can make out from this etching. There you go. I didn't doubt you for a second. Let's see what's in here.
Yes!
Thank you.
another mention of the Guardian. This is the Guardian's tomb we're standing in now. It says that he was loyal, and his reward was an honorable death. Quite fascinating. How amazing! A real dragon priest. In all my years as a historian, I never thought I'd see anything like that.
I suppose that was Valak. He must have had this entire place built for him so that he could maintain his vigil, even beyond death. Indeed. I knew that the dragon priests were thought to have been powerful men of great will, but I had no idea. Well, I suppose I've seen everything I came for, and you kept up your end of the bargain. I promised payment, and here it is. Now I think I'll spend some more time studying this word war. What a book this will make! History truly comes alive here, don't you think? I've been thinking about that, and I believe it does. I believe it was the ancient ancestors of the Skull who built this tomb for their master, a dragon priest they called the Guardian. In all likelihood, these people were ancient Nords who came with a dragon priest to live here on Solstheim. Separated from their people on the mainland, they developed a distinct culture that became the Skull we know today. Of course, this is all just theory and conjecture. It is likely we will never know the truth. This is clearly a tomb, if a rather elaborate one. I would guess it was built for a dragon priest who achieved great fame in his time. It seems he was held in high regard by both men and dragons, because he defeated a traitor named Mirak. Perhaps Mirak was also a dragon priest, probably a contemporary of this Guardian. He must have turned against his own order. After his defeat, Mirak was banished to Solstheim, and the Guardian was made his jailer. A good question. Partly to keep unwanted intruders away, I suppose. They might also have been meant as tests, to ensure that only the truly worthy can reach the main burial chamber. Who can say, really? The motives of the dragon priests are as inscrutable as those of the dragons they worship. Right then.
You must know, I'm trying to get this Ash Guardian spell to work. Now let me concentrate. Besides, shouldn't you be worrying about the damage to the tower?
Master Neloth has tasked Alenia with repairing the tower. Doing this in the lab, where it would be safer for all of us.
The lab is too small. Also, I need the ashy soil. Master Neloth knows what I'm doing. No need to bother him about it, though. He's quite busy at the moment.
It's on your head if something goes wrong. Just let me get back inside.
No, Ash Guardian. I don't think you belong here. Does Master Neloth know about you? Yes, I'm trying to summon an Ash Guardian. Just having trouble deciphering Master Neloth's handwriting. I don't mean to be rude, but I need to concentrate.
We don't get many visitors. Is there something you need?
Yes? This is Master Neloth's tower. He's a Telvanni wizard. You've never heard of the great houses of Morrowind? House Telvanni is the house of the Master Wizard, one of the ruling houses of Morrowind. Master Neloth is one of the oldest and most respected members of House Telvanni. Not so much with, as for. I am Master Neloth's apprentice. He's teaching me the art of sorcery. Well, he is a very great wizard. It's a great honor for him to have taken me as his apprentice. To be honest, it's horrible. He's very unpleasant and hardly teaches me anything. Sometimes he uses me in his experiments. Even so, I pick up a lot from just watching him. I'd better get going. Another border. No, etheric order. I think that's right.
Yes!
I hope you're not expecting a meal. I've barely got enough for them that live here. Yes, Sarah?
Damn that man. He's being totally unreasonable. I don't care if he's a master wizard. He can't treat me like this. That fetcher told me to fix his house. If I don't, he'll find a new mycologist who will. Decades of loyal service, and he'd just throw me out like yesterday's breakfast. Three taproots soaked in the headwaters of the Harstrad River. I'm an old woman. I can't possibly make that trip. It's way too dangerous. If you get some taproots, I'll pay you to dip them in the headwaters and bring them to me. Yes, that was a lifetime ago. I was just a young girl when Red Mountain erupted. Master Neloth was already old. My mother put me on a boat to Skyrim. The last time I ever saw her, she was standing on the dock as my ship sailed away. It it's special to the Spriggans. They seem to like to gather there. Something about the waters attracts them. There are bound to be some there, so be careful. Where do you think? You have to cut it out of a Spriggan. Although sometimes you can buy them from alchemists. I am his mycologist. He may have grown Tel-Mithrin by himself, but I nurture it. Mushrooms and fungi are my life's work. When I saw Tel-Mithrin, I knew I had to be here. I've learned so much since then. Me? No. That's Master Neloth's doing. I wasn't even born then. It's Tel'Vani magic at its best. He brought the cuttings with him from Morrowind, and used sorcery to grow them. I've got the best selection of mushroom and fungi. Azura, light your steps. I like it here at Tel-Mithrin. Hardly anyone bothers me. People can be so irritating.
You again? Didn't I see you in Ravenrock? You refer to the tomes of esoteric knowledge that old Hermaeus Mora has scattered throughout the world? Is this somehow connected to your search for Mira? Have you? The actual Arcana Infinium, that's it. I've searched for it myself for many years, without success. Well then, you should know better than anyone that Hermaeus Mora is not to be trifled with. But he is subtler than most of the other Daedric princes, as you would expect of the Prince of Knowledge and Fate. You seem to have escaped the fate of many who find themselves ensnared forever by the lore of his secrets. Or perhaps not. Found one? Yes. And you read it too, didn't you? Don't try to deny it. You've got the look. I can see it now. Dangerous knowledge is still knowledge and therefore useful. Usually turns out to be the most useful, in my experience. Now that is a dangerous path indeed. Hermaeus Mora gives nothing away for free. You may end up like Mirak, of course. Two power mad dragonborn. It could be very interesting. Oh yes, they're not hard to locate once you know how to look for them. I have one here that I've been using to locate more. Yes, I haven't been idle while this fascinating madness engulfed Solstheim. But my book isn't what you're looking for. I'm quite sure it is unconnected with this Mirak. But I do know where to find a black book that can help you. Yes, I do. I haven't been able to get it, though. But maybe together we can unlock the secrets the Dwemer left behind. Forbidden knowledge was somewhat of a specialty of the dwarves, eh? You don't think they would just leave it alone, do you? It seems the ancient Dwemer discovered this book and took it to study. I found their reading room in the ruins of Nachardak. The book is there, but it's sealed in a protective case which I wasn't able to open. But perhaps the two of us together will be able to get at the book. To Nachardak, then. You again. Didn't I see you? Is this somehow connected to your search for Mira? Found what? Dangerous knowledge is still knowledge, and now that you may end up like Mirak of... Oh yes, they're not hard. Yes, I have. But I do know where to find a black book that can help you. Yes, I do. I haven't been able to get it, though. But maybe together we can unlock... Forbidden knowledge. It seems the ancient Dwemer discovered this book and took it to but perhaps to Nachardak then. Follow me. certainly knew how to build for the ages. These towers have outlasted their creators by millennia. The book is housed inside that dome. I'll need to unlock the door for us. Let's get on with it.